Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. How's everybody doing today? I hope you're doing good. And I hope you're ready to listen to the third part of the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam. So far, mashallah, I've been looking at your homeworks or your assignments, for lack of, I think assignment is a better word, right? We don't like homework. We like assignments. Your assignments have been amazing. And your videos have really, really touched me. Alhamdulillah, I love them, and I love your pictures. By the way, next week on Monday, we're going to play all of the pictures that you sent me. The boat, and some of you still sent me the tree picture. So I'm gonna play all the pictures together, inshallah, and then I'm gonna choose one of them for the winning prize, inshallah, which I will tell you at the end of the series, inshallah ta'ala. So your du'as have been amazing, and your videos are going to play at the end of this video, inshallah, today. Right? When I'm done talking, you stay there in front of the TV because you might see yourself. Okay? So the du'as that we learned so far are A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. And the second was Bismillah alladhi la yadurru ma'ismihi shay'un fil ardi wala fis sama' wa huwa as-sami'ul 'alim. Right? The third dua is A'udhu bi kalimatillahi tammat min sharri ma khalaq. So these du'as protect us from the shaitan, and they protect us from evils. And when we say this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect us from all of these evils around us, inshallah ta'ala. But you have to trust in Allah. You have to be a strong believer. Are you a strong believer? I hope your answer was yes. Because today we're going to see how one of the strongest believers in the history of mankind, Ibrahim alayhi salam, how he was protected by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and how he was guided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Are you ready? Okay. So where did we stop yesterday? Do you guys remember? We stopped when Ibrahim alayhi salam left his wife Hajar and his son Ismail in Mecca. So he left them in Mecca and he went to Asham for many years. And then he came back to Mecca to find Ismail, a big grown boy, mashallah. Okay? He might have been your age. I don't know how old you are, but he might have been your age. So when he came back and he saw Hajar, it was so nice. He was so happy to see his family after a long time. He said, Alhamdulillah, look at my boy Ismail. He's such a grown boy, Alhamdulillah. But when he was there and in the midst of all of this fun, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed Ibrahim alayhi salam something in a dream. And he showed him, he gave him a command in the form of showing, because this is how prophets used to see, used to receive revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sometimes they would receive revelation by an angel like Jibreel alayhi salam, and sometimes they will dream. And in the dream, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tell them what He wants them to do or what He wants them to say. So Ibrahim alayhi salam saw that he was killing his son Ismail. Yes, I know it's hard. But he woke up and he said, I can't. How? He said, Ya Allah, I did everything you asked me. Ya Allah, I'm sure that you cannot ask me to do anything that's bad for me. It's impossible for Allah to ask us to do something that's bad for us. There's no way that's possible. Everything Allah asks from us is good. And Ibrahim knew this. But when he had this dream, He was shocked. He didn't know what to think. He said, my beautiful son, I love him and I came all the way from Sham just to see him. It took me months and I'm so happy with him. How am I going to do this? But he said, if Allah asked me, I must do it. Because I know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants me to do it for a good reason. Look at the iman he had. So much faith, mashallah. We all want faith like this. So Ibrahim goes to his son Ismail, and he told him, my son, I want to tell you something. He said, what? He said, I saw in a dream that God is commanding me to kill you. And you know what Ismail said? He was a young boy. He might have been your age. But he was full of iman and faith, inshallah, the way you are. And you know what he said? Because he knows Allah will never command any of his servants to do something that's bad for them. Allah only asks us to do things that are good for us. So Ismail knew this. And you know what he replied? He said, yes, father, you can go and kill me. If God told you to do it, then there has to be something good in it. And Ibrahim was so happy that his son helped him in fulfilling the command of Allah. He helped him and he told him, yes, my father, yes. We always want to be like that. We always want to say yes to the command of Allah. Because Allah created us and He's more merciful to us than even our mothers and fathers. Yes. So Ibrahim took Ismail, and before he actually went to kill him, he went and told his wife. And his wife said, is that what Allah told you to do? Ibrahim said, yes. She said, but he's my son, but I'm okay. Of course she cried, because she thought she was going to lose her son. No one wants to see their son die, but she was a believer as well. So before this happened, Shaytan came in the form of an old, wretched, ugly man. And he walked up to Ibrahim and he told him, and it was in this place called Mina. Okay, it's still there in Mecca until today. And that's where we go to in Hajj to throw stones. And now you're about to find out why we throw stones. So Iblis went to Ibrahim alayhi salam and he told him, hey, what kind of God is this? He told you to do so many things, but this one, I don't think you should obey God. He's telling you to kill your own son. How was this possible? So Ibrahim said, Allah told me to do it, therefore it's good for me. You don't understand? He said, Ikhsa adu Allah. You enemy of Allah, get out of here. He picked up 7 stones and he threw it at Iblis. And then he went to Hajar, the mother. He's going to kill your son. How are you going to let this old man who came from Sham kill your son? I know he's your husband and I know he's a prophet, but how are you going to let him do this? She said, Ikhsa adu Allah, go you enemy of God, you enemy of Allah. I trust in Allah. She threw 7 stones at him. And then he did the same thing to Ismail and he told him the same thing, and Ismail replied the same thing because they're all true believers, alhamdulillah. Picked up 7 stones and he threw it at Iblis. So Iblis said, oh, these people are too faithful. They're too much of a believer for me. I can't lure them. I can't sway them away from the command of Allah. So when the time came, Ibrahim alayhi salam, he was sharpening the knife so that it doesn't hurt when he comes to kill his son. And obviously his heart is in pain when he's doing this, because it's his own son. But he knows Allah, the Lord of him, and the one who created him, and the one who created his son, and the one who created the love that he has for him, is asking him to do it. So he knows he must do it. So he's sharpening the blade, and he's like, Ya Allah, make it easy. Ya Allah, make it easy. So he comes, and he puts Ismail down, and Ismail was a young boy, and he closed his eyes. He's like, Dad, just do it, Dad. It's okay. And then he told him, Dad, maybe when you're looking at my face, it'll be hard for you. So how about you put my face downwards, so I look at the floor. So he did that. And Ibrahim was perhaps crying when he did this. His heart was in so much pain. He lifted the sword up. And as he was going to strike, he said, Bismillah, Allahu Akbar, and he strikes, and then boom! Nothing happens to Ismail. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not let the sword enter into him. It didn't even scratch him. So Ibrahim, he said, well, what is this? What's going on? Is the sword not sharp? And then the angels come from the sky, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls on Ibrahim and says, you قد صدقت الرؤيا, you fulfilled the dream, and you fulfilled the ultimate command of Allah, something that tested you so much that made you the imam of mankind until the day of judgment. Allah made Ibrahim the imam of all the human race until the day of judgment because of this great sacrifice he did. He showed Allah that he's willing to do anything for the sake of Allah, and he truly believes and trusts in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when this happened, Ibrahim was surprised. He said, what is going on? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, you have won the ultimate winning, and you deserve the greatest prize. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down with the angels a kebsh, okay? A sheep, a big fat sheep that grazed in Jannah and ate from the plants of Jannah for years. So it was big and it was fat and it was healthy and it was from Jannah. And that makes it so much better. And he says, today you can slaughter this sheep, and then you can eat from it and feed your family from it, and you can have a big feast. Allahu Akbar. And everyone ate, and he said Alhamdulillah, and he hugged his son Ismail, and Hajar hugged them both, and they all lived happily, Alhamdulillah, because they fulfilled and trusted in Allah. They fulfilled Allah's command. They trusted in Allah, so Allah gave them the greatest reward. By the way, that's why in Eid al-Adha, not the first Eid, not the Eid of Ramadan, the second Eid, Eid al-Adha, which is when they do Hajj, that's why we slaughter a sheep. Because that's what Ibrahim alayhi salam did on this day. It was the 10th day of Dhul-Hijjah, and it was the day of Eid. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Inshallah, this year in Eid, I want all of you to remember this story when your father takes you or your mother takes you to slaughter a sheep so you can eat and feed everyone in your family from it, inshallah ta'ala. Okay? So this was a great day. So the lesson we learn from this is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never ask us to do something that's bad for us. Allah tells us to do things so He can test our faith. Okay? So next time, I want you to pass the test. Okay? When mom or dad tell you to make wudu, they tell you to pray, they tell you to read Quran or to study, I want you to listen to them, because this is your test, okay? And if you pass your test, then you truly submit to Allah. May Allah make us true believers. Say Ameen. Okay? So today's dua, inshallah, is a very, very nice dua. And I want you to send me videos of it. Okay? I loved your videos, by the way. Mashallah, you're so amazing. You guys are all awesome. You're awesome. But there are a lot more that still didn't send me a video. So I want you to send me a video today. Okay? To the email that we have on the bottom of the screen, inshallah. Today's dua is, and I want you to repeat after me. La ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu min al-zalimin. Okay, let's say it again. La ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu min al-zalimin. Now this dua is very special because it's the dua of Yunus alayhi salam, one of the prophets. We're going to talk about Yunus, inshallah, soon. And this dua, our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, don't forget to say sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Anytime you hear Muhammad, you say sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He said, whichever Muslim makes dua using this dua that I just taught you will be answered. Any Muslim who makes dua using this dua that I told you will be answered, inshallah. But make sure you ask for good things, right? Don't go ask for like a lot of candy, you know, because we know it's going to give you cavities, give you a stomachache, you won't be able to sleep. So ask for something that's good, inshallah. Okay? Jazakumullah khair. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Listen to the videos.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My name is Zain Khan. A'udhu bi kalimatillahi at-tammati min sharri ma khalaq. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My name is Zain Khan. A'udhu bi kalimatillahi at-tammati min sharri ma khalaq.
Assalamu alaikum, and my name is Sajidur Rahman Bermudez, and I'm going to be reciting two du'as. The first one, you have to say it once during the day, whenever you wake up. A'udhu bi kalimati Allahi tammati min sharri ma khalaq. And the second one, you have to say it three times in the morning and three times in the evening, so that Allah will not bring you upon any harm. Bismillah alladhi la yaduru ma'asmihi shay'un fil ardi wa la fis sama wa huwa as-samiul alim.
Wa alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My name is Hamza Ahmed. I'm going to say this dua. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. A'udhu bi kalimati Allah at-tammati min sharri ma khalaq.
Hello, my name is Lena Bidat, and I am 6 years old, and I'm going to say this dua to send it to Epic, Ustadh, and it is Epic. And here we start. A'udhu bi kalimati Allahi at-tammati min sharri ma khalaq. Assalamu alaikum.
إن المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات والقانتين والقانتات والصادقين والصادقات والصابرين والصابرات والخاشعين والخاشعات والخاشعين والخاشعات والمتصدقين والمتصدقات والصائمين والصائمات والحافظين فروجهم والحافظات والذاكرين الله كثيرا والذاكرات أعد الله لهم مغفرة وأجرا عظيما. وأجرا عظيما.